Good morning, students. In our previous class, we have understood that respiration contains five events. What are those? Can you recollect them? The first one is breathing, then gaseous exchange at lung level, then gas transport by blood, gaseous exchange at tissue level, and finally cellular respiration. So we have already finished this breathing, and now let us see gaseous exchange at lungs level. So, gaseous exchange means exchange of gases. Which gases are exchanged? Oxygen is exchanged for carbon dioxide. Where it is in lungs? Students, inside lungs, where this exchange happens exactly? Students, I already told that lungs are divided into sac-like structures. How many such sacs are present? Do you know, students, per lung 600 million sacs are present, and these sacs are called as alveoli. Plural is alveoli and singular is alveolus. So this is one alveolus of lung, and this alveoli are surrounded by blood capillaries. See here, one capillary is shown, but many capillaries are present around it. Now when you take breath in, when you inhale air, what happens? Lungs are filled with air. Lungs means the alveoli are filled with air. So now during inhalation, the alveoli are filled with air. And this air contains oxygen, carbon dioxide, nitrogen and many other gases. Now this capillary is coming from tissues. These tissues are continuously respiring and producing carbon dioxide, and that carbon dioxide is brought to the lung surface or alveolar surface. Now this blood is rich with carbon dioxide and this is rich with oxygen. But students, do you know this blood also contains oxygen? Little bit of oxygen will be there. Now what happens? This has more carbon dioxide, this has more oxygen. So oxygen from alveolus enters into blood and carbon dioxide from capillary enters into alveolus. By what process? By diffusion. What is diffusion? Movement of gases from high pressure to low pressure area. So inside alveolus, the pressure of oxygen is more. So it moves from alveolus into blood capillary. And here the pressure of carbon dioxide is more, so it enters into alveolus. Students, see here the numbers. These numbers are not required, but this is for just your understanding. Inside the alveolus during inhalation, the pressure of the oxygen will be 100 mm of Hg and carbon dioxide is 40 mm of Hg. And inside the capillary, the oxygen pressure is 40 mm of Hg and carbon dioxide is 46 mm of Hg. So students, tell me how the gases move. In what direction the oxygen moves? From alveolus to capillary. In what direction carbon dioxide moves? From capillary to alveolus. So it is by pressure difference the diffusion process occurs. Got it, student? Pressure ettupakke kunde atu nunchi pressure takkunde area ki move avutayi. So and ela move avutayi? Diffusion process dwara move avutayi. Got it, students? This is about gaseous exchange in lungs. Now, our next event is gas transport. What is this transport, gas transport? Who transports gases? It is blood. So, blood transports oxygen from lungs to tissues and it transports carbon dioxide from tissues to lungs. Let us take up transport of oxygen now. So, how does this transport of oxygen takes place? Students, the oxygen from lungs enter into blood, and inside blood there are RBC, right? And that RBC contains hemoglobin, the red color pigment inside. So oxygen combines with hemoglobin of RBC and forms oxyhemoglobin, HbO2. And it is in this form, it is transported from lungs to tissues. And at the tissue surface, the HbO2 dissociates to form Hb and O2 inside blood. And then oxygen enters into tissues. Did you understand, students? I hope you understood. Now let us take up transport of carbon dioxide. Less than 2% of carbon dioxide is transported as same as oxygen. See, carbon dioxide from tissues enter into blood, and inside blood they combine with Hb to form carboxyhemoglobin, HbCO2, and this is just 2%. Now the remaining carbon dioxide enters into blood. Inside blood there is a liquid substance called plasma, and this carbon dioxide reacts with water of the plasma to form carbonic acid. This carbonic acid, being weak, it dissociates to form H plus and HCO3 minus ions. These are called as bicarbonate ions. So it is in this form the blood transports carbon dioxide to the lungs. Got it, students? So now at the lung surface, the bicarbonate ions combine with H plus and again they form carbonic acid. See here, HCO3 minus plus H plus giving rise to H2CO3. Now this carbonic acid again dissociates to form carbon dioxide and water at the lung surface inside blood. Now after this dissociation, the carbon dioxide enters into alveoli. See here, this is alveolus and this is the blood capillary which is having RBC. So during inhalation, what happens? Oxygen from lung alveoli enters into blood, and inside blood oxygen combines with hemoglobin to form oxyhemoglobin, and this oxyhemoglobin is transported to the tissues. Now see here, carbon dioxide is brought from tissues in what form? Bicarbonate form. So at the lung surface, these bicarbonate ions are joining with H plus again and forming carbonic acid. Carbonic acid again dissociates to form carbon dioxide and water, and this carbon dioxide is then enters into the alveoli. Got it, students? Understood? So in what form carbon dioxide is transported inside blood? It is in the form of bicarbonate ions. Less than 2% it is by carboxyhemoglobin. In what form oxygen is transported? It is by oxyhemoglobin form. But it students, this is about gas transport by blood. Now the next event in respiration is gaseous exchange at tissues. Now students, blood is bringing what? Blood is bringing oxygen to the tissues, right? But that blood contains even carbon dioxide too. See, this arterial blood means blood coming from lungs. So it is having oxygen and also carbon dioxide. Now our tissues. Tissues are containing carbon dioxide and also oxygen. But see the pressures. The pressure of carbon dioxide is 46 and oxygen is 40. But in the blood, oxygen concentration is, or pressure is 100 mm of Hg. Carbon dioxide is 40. So what happens, students? Oxygen enters from blood into tissues. Carbon dioxide enters from tissues into blood. This carbon dioxide is again taken to lungs for the next round of exchange with oxygen. Got it, students? So arterial blood means blood coming from lungs. It is rich with oxygen and poor with carbon dioxide. This blood exchanges oxygen for carbon dioxide in tissues. Oxygen goes to tissues, carbon dioxide enters into blood. Now the blood is rich with carbon dioxide and this blood is called as venous blood. This blood goes to lung again for oxygenation, means exchange with oxygen. That blood comes out as arterial blood again to the tissues. This cycle goes on. Got it, students? I hope you understood. Thank you.